of them voted. And you know 71% voted for President Obama. We go, why that happened, we'll talk a little bit more later. In a country where more than 50 million people are considered Hispanics, where 24 million are registered to vote for a president, it is your responsibility to make sure that those people know what you know. It is your responsibility to make sure that these people know who is running the White House now. Because of one reason. We don't have media in the United States, and everybody knows that. We have a media crisis. And that media crisis is not just limited to the English language. That media crisis goes all over to more than 100 languages, different languages. And because Hispanics are the number one minority group in the United States that shouldn't be called minority anymore by the numbers, they know that's a big target they need to keep misinformed. The more misinformed the Hispanics are, the better the chances they do win the elections. That happened over the last 30 or 40 years, and it's happening even worse in years. The Hispanic vote is, I would say, probably the biggest challenge in politics in the United States right now. Because doesn't matter what you guys do, believe me, I'm dealing with this almost every day for the last 5 years, and it's very frustrating. Doesn't matter what you guys do, what rallies you go, what conventions you go, petitions, anything you do, if you don't reach the people that you need to reach to win the elections, you are preaching to the choir. That's the bottom line. If we are preaching to the choir, I did it for a very long time. I try not to do it too much anymore, but that's the case. I'll give you one example that demonstrates with clarity that when you reach Hispanics, you win. But you need to know how to reach Hispanics. We're going to go over that later on. What happened last year in New Jersey with Governor Christie? Here you have a state which is a very well-known Democrat state, a Republican governor who wanted to be re-elected. He won with more than 50% of the Hispanic vote. More than 50%. And the question here is, why that happened? Can that happen in other states? Why other Republicans were not able to do that? And the answer is very simple. He did what the Democrats do. He campaigned in Spanish. He had Hispanic ads. He campaigned in areas heavily populated by Hispanics. I don't know who told, maybe somebody from the Democratic Party told him you have to do that. But you know the results. He won. He won. A Republican being re-elected for governor in New Jersey. Hard to believe that happened. How do you think that Harvey Reed was re-elected? I mean, somebody like Harvey Reed to be re-elected is not kind of crazy, right? But he was re-elected with a Hispanic vote. 71% of the Hispanics voted for President Obama in this past election, 67% voting in 2008. So whatever we did in the country, it didn't work. Actually, it was worse. It was worse. And it will be worse in 2016 if we keep doing the same thing. When I talk about media, I talk about mainly one name, or I can mention many. It's called Univision. Univision is the largest source of information for the Hispanic community in the U.S. Univision reaches 97% of Hispanics. 97%. When you combine any other or many others, websites, newspapers, I mean, any kind of source of information, they don't even get close to what Univision can do. And you know what Univision does. Univision. I spell it. Univision. Univision. That's Univision. It's all over the United States. and it's also in other countries. Univision was purchased by a guy by Egypt. Egypt for $12 billion. When you open Univision, I don't know if they still do that, because they accomplished what they wanted, Obamacare. When you open Univision in the past, the first thing you saw and the first thing you heard was propaganda about Obamacare. Everything you guys heard about Obamacare coming, all the information that we read almost daily about Obamacare was never there. So when you ask a Hispanic, what about Obamacare? What do you think they're going to think?
Great.
Right? That's an example. I can give you many other examples, but that's probably the best example. The Democratic Party campaign all year around in every state in Hispanics. While we are thinking whether or not we should do that. Sadly, that that's the case. When I talk about media, I like to say this because I think this is the case. If Fox News were in Spanish, President Obama would never be elected president. We have amazing sources of information in Spanish. We have, you know, the Place, the Private, the Heritage Foundation, Town Hall Magazine, Human Events, you name it. We have a lot. But in Spanish, they're very few. They're very few. And it's kind of hard to believe, and for me, it's something that I have hard time to understand. If you're losing the elections because of the Hispanic vote, and you don't do anything about it, why do you even complain? The Hispanic will determine the elections outcome in the US for generations to come. And it will be worse and worse and worse in terms of outcome, unless we do something about it. Now, keep in mind something. Hispanics don't vote for the left because they are leftists. Hispanics are not extreme liberals. The majority of Hispanics that live in this country, the great majority, are believers, hardworking people. They move here for a better quality of life, for the opportunity for the free market. Hispanics don't come here looking for socialism. That's not true. If they want you to believe that that's the case, that's a lie. It's a flat lie. Hispanics and everybody else, not just Hispanics, come to this country because America is the dream destination for many people around the world. The American, the Hispanic dream, or I would say the immigrant dream, is the American dream. The immigrant dream is not a socialist dream. It never was, and it never will. So this is very important to remember. Another thing that is hard to believe, but this is the case again. As we speak, despite all the situations and all the problems and challenges that we have with the Hispanic vote, we don't have one single TV channel that support the conservative Hispanic values. 2014, in a country where more than 50 million Hispanics live, we don't have not even one channel, that support the Hispanic conservative movement. And what do they have? CNN, El Mundo, Univision, those are the main ones. I can count more. So, what you're trying to do is to win a war that cannot be won. And I don't want to try, don't please, I am not a pessimistic kind of person. I am realistic. All I am giving you is the numbers and the facts. And you make the decision whether or not this can be won. There's only one way that can be won. If you become the media. Not just in English, but also in Spanish. Because the truth never gonna come out from these people. They want to make sure that Hispanics are misinformed. You know, the success and the power of a socialist government, of a leftist government, depend on the misinformation of the people. And the more information they hide from you, the more successful they will be. Why do you think that every source of information is denied right now in Venezuela? Because they want people to know what's happening? They're not even Twitter, no Facebook, no Twitter, no newspapers, no TV channels. It's the same thing that happened in every communist country. We don't have that situation at that level here. But the truth is not being delivered to the people that will decide the elections. If that information doesn't come from you, it will never be there. Never. There are some organizations that are doing something. If somebody raise your hand before 3 minutes, because I have a lot of things that I'd like to tell you. The Heritage Foundation realized that this is a problem that needs to be faced several years ago, and they launched a Hispanic version. The Heritage Foundation. The free market, I don't know if you guys read the free market, they realized that Hispanics need to know about free market. They launched a Hispanic version. The Christian Post, they're very aware about what's going on with Christianity right now. They launched a Hispanic version. Liberty Council. We have several projects together with Liberty Council in the past. We're still working with them right now. They realized that. And they launched a radio program in Spanish called A Call for Freedom. A Call for Freedom. In Spanish is Llamado de Libertad. That comes from Liberty University. Every day in Spanish. There are other organizations. Now my question to you is, if these people are doing that, why don't you do it? They're doing this because they know it's needed. It is an emergency. You live in Florida. This room should be full of Hispanic people. Don't tell me you don't know a Hispanic person. Don't tell me you don't have a relative who is Hispanic, or don't tell me you don't know somebody who knows a Hispanic person. What about their children? You know, one day I was being interviewed in D.C. during the Obamacare, the Tea Party invited me to talk about the Obamacare situation. And some of these, I think the Washington Division approached me in they were talking about, you know, Hispanics and you guys, the parties, and you know, you're racist, and you know, anti-immigration. The same thing that they always tell you. And those days, you know, I used to have a thought about what the Tea Party is all about. And because I love the Tea Party. And, I mean, the Tea Party is one of the best things that happened in the United States, in my opinion, in the last few years. And I go, you know, I know you don't like the Tea Party, I know exactly what you think, but I'm going to ask you a few questions. And if you disagree, please tell me from your heart that you disagree with this. And I go, we believe in limited government. We believe in God, because most of the Tea Party people believe in God. We believe in national security. We believe in personal responsibility. And I went on and on, you know, but if you think about all the Tea Party people, they believe in about 18 different core values that almost everybody shares. And I say, okay, I want to go one by one. If you disagree with any one of these, just tell me, but tell me why. I really want to know. And when I finish my list, and I say, you didn't tell me anything. That means that you disagree with all of them, or maybe you don't disagree with anything. And still this person didn't mention one word. And I say, if you didn't say one word, it's because you agree with this. And you couldn't say anything. Now, if you disagree with this, you shouldn't be living in this country. It's simple like that. What we're trying to do is to make sure that people understand that this is an emergency. I met some of you guys before in the last 5 years. When I started doing this, I know some people ignore this. They did ignore it because maybe they didn't know how important it was. Maybe they didn't know the power of the Latino vote. Maybe they didn't know that there's going to be 24 million Hispanic registered to vote. 71% voting for him. But you should know that now. And as we speak, as I said before, they are campaigning everywhere in the country while we're doing nothing. If you go to Cinco de Mayo event, if you go to the National Hispanic Expo event, the National Hispanic Expo event is in Florida every year. All the Hispanics, most of the Hispanic business get together in Orlando once a year. It's a huge event in the convention center. American for Prosperity called me one day and said, you know, let's go there and maybe have a table and try to, you know, send the message out, talk to the Hispanic community. So I went and we have a great table and we talked to some people. They have some shirts and some pants and some other things that we gave away. And then I say, you know, to the rest of the people on the table, I'm going to walk around here because this is amazing. I mean, the World Convention Center is full with Hispanic business people. So I walk around and then I saw a table over there that said Obama.
Yeah.
You know, I said, wow, Spectre, right? So I just want to say, I said, I'm going to go there and I'm going to talk to this man. And I said, those were, well, that was 2 years ago, everybody was talking about Obamacare. So I said, what do you like about Obamacare? And they start telling me why they like Obamacare, and I start saying why I don't like Obamacare. The out of the blue, I was surrounded by 15 people, close to 15 people, insulting me. How bad I am, how anti-Latino I am, how anti-immigration, anti-Obama I am, just because I wanted to tell him the truth about Obamacare. The thing that was never released in Univision. And I can tell you so much about my care, because as a doctor, I see things that you guys don't see. Many doctors are selling their practices to the hospitals, because only hospitals can buy practices. Many patients are losing the doctors. The premiums are up, yes, the premiums are up, with no question about it. People are losing the jobs, they are losing the jobs, no question about it. I see it every day. Doctors, nurses, technicians, everybody. But this is not about Obamacare right now. So what we do, I'm gonna show you a couple of slides here. Like a movie. Let me scroll down this. What we do through Bear Witness. Bear Witness also created Libertad USA. Libertad USA means Freedom USA in English, which is a compilation of several conservative, Hispanic, national and international organizations. What we decided to do is that we're going to put together a website to inform the Hispanics what the liberal media would never say. And here we have Heritage Foundation, the Christian Post in Spanish, we have the Free Market, The Economist, and many others. This is updated every day. And whatever happened in the country, which is important for Hispanics to know, is there in the next 24 to 48 hours. Go down a little, okay, stay there. Yeah, that's fine. This is the Tea Party Pennsylvania chapter. What you see there, I don't have a point right now, but you probably can read Libertad USA.
Right there?
Okay. Libertad USA, that's our website. All we ask people, if you want to reach Hispanics, we facilitate that for you. We set it up for you. We send you the logo. All you have to do is to copy and paste this logo on the front page of your website, and then you have it. When you click the logo, you access the website. How much is it going to cost you? Zero. How fast it's going to be? You can do it in less than 5 minutes. How effective it's going to be? Very effective. Because you will have on your website, on the front page of your website, permanent stores of information for the Hispanic community all year around. You don't have to look for anything. You don't have to translate anything. Everything will be there updated by us. This is the Pennsylvania, is located in Philadelphia, the Tea Party Patriot chapter. They also request daily information. So we say, okay, we're gonna send you daily information. And we send an article every day about something important that happened in the last 24, 40 hours. You know, whatever happened in the country. For example, right now, what's going on in Nevada, you know, we try to get it in Spanish. Common Core, Executive Orders, Obamacare, Gun Control, everything is there. Everything is there. So if somebody, for whatever reason, doesn't want to read in English, cannot read in English, but wants to know the truth, can go there. This is the Tea Party Patriot Pennsylvania chapter in Philadelphia. You can see Libertad USA there. That's the American Hispanic Coalition that we created in different Hispanic organizations, but that's a different thing. Can you get this other one? While he's looking for that, I want to show you the Villages Tea Party website. The Villages Tea Party website is a very comprehensive website, and they do care about this situation. And we provide all the Hispanic information for the villages. One thing that is very important, and I am glad that you guys are firming this, because this is the way to transmit and to spread information across the country. Videos are very important, because as you see, we don't have minorities here. But these videos can be sent all over the country, every state, if you want to do it. This is the way to educate people these days. If they don't go to you, you go to them. And the way you go to them, you're not going to travel all over the country to visit Hispanics. The way to reach them is doing these kind of things. You send those videos to all your friends, and ask your friends to send those videos to their friends and tell them, we want to make sure that this goes all over the country. I'll tell you about this, an example of how effective this is. On January 18th,